Kameli Setback, reporting.
What do you make of some of boxing circles being so dismissive of this fight? Is that something that motivates you?
It's certainly motivating. I mean, the disrespect or the disregard to my skill set is, you know, I look at people so many times and they have such a, their mind is closed. They've got a closed mind to how things can be done. It's a set way and there's no other way. If that was the case, we'd never have reached across the waters and searched of other land. We never have went into space. Or, you know what I mean? You've got to have an open mind and you've got to realize that there are other ways and there is a time and a place for every single room. You've got to give respect for other disciplines and other styles. Like, for instance, fighting is a complex game. There's a time and a place for every single attack and every single move. It's about finding the correct timing for it. So when I hear the way they carry on and their disregard, disrespect, you know, it is what it is. I use it as motivation and I look forward to going in and educating and then, but at the same time I get it, you know, I'm coming in, I'm supposed to be from the other, another sport. So again, I understand where it's at, but I'm just looking forward to August 26th, going in and proving what I'm saying. And then educating the world on what martial arts is, and giving the fans and everybody a good solid fight, and earning my respect in this game also.
And as an unrelated follow-up, in the UFC you can't always wear personal sponsors, logos, and endorsements like that. Are you looking forward to that? What do you have planned endorsement-wise for August?
Yeah, I've got a couple of entities in the brand that's with me. I also signed with Bet Safe, and then as far as an apparel deal, we're close to an apparel deal. But at the same time, I'm in no rush. I've got good endorsement deals, and as far as in-ring endorsements, they are two of that will be on the charts, I believe. But look, there's so many moving parts in the game. I'm just kind of trying to roll with it and. Look, it's 10 days from the fight time, so I leave this to my agency, my management agency at Paradigm Sports Management, to handle that side of the business. But it is certainly a good business, so I'm very happy with everything that's been going on the endorsement side.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Our next question is going to come from Daniel Matthews from the Daily Mirror UK. Please go ahead.
Hi, Connor. I just wondered how your preparation and also the build-up kind of outside around you is different from your big UFC fights and whether that's affected your preparations at all.
Oh, look, it's another day for me. It's another day of making history. It's another day of doing what I've been told I shouldn't be doing or I can't do, and then it's another mega blockbuster event. It's nothing new to me here, so. The only difference in this build-up is that I have a little son now with me, so we are here in Las Vegas as a family, and my coaches and sparring partners and team, they have their multiple houses close by. So it's just been, for me, it's just been, I go to the gym, I train really hard for that given day, I come home, I rest and chill with my family, and then I repeat. And then the media and the circus around it, it's business as usual. It's the exact same.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekpak.